Hello, VN devs. Your visual novel is hot garbage. Whew, now that the hard part's out of the way, the not-so-shocking truth is that a large majority of indie visual novels are just frankly hot garbage. And while I continue to give them a chance, they just continue to disappoint me. Now, I'm not out here to say that you need to make a visual novel to my or anybody else's liking. It may be a passion project to refine your writing skills, perhaps your first venture into game design, or maybe you want to reinvent the wheel by coding a small visual novel from scratch. And I get that. But unless you know the inner workings of what makes a visual novel great, don't release it on Steam and expect everyone to love it. Because they won't. Especially if it looks like, this. I can't teach you the design process that goes behind the development of visual novels, nor the technical aspects of them. You got people like Vimy and Zeal for that. But I can tell you why your visual novel is hot garbage, because not only have I read 99 visual novels to date, I also happen to be an expert of what I do not like. So without further ado, let me tell you why your visual novel sucks. I mean, what do you want me to say here, man? There are many misconceptions about visual novels. When people out of the loop think of visual novels, they think of dating sims, Ace Attorney, and that Nukigay furry Buddha shit. Especially the Nukigay furry Buddha shit, because since coming out as a visual novel player to my friends, that's all they give me. Very funny, guys. And whilst those VNs would technically be encompassed within the genre of visual novels, they're not representative of the entire genre as a whole. But even if you are aware of the difference, if you don't read visual novels, you're no better off than someone who doesn't even know what a visual novel is. I get that visual novels can be classified as games, and if it's your first venture into game development, then it makes sense you'll want to start small. But I can guarantee you, if you haven't at least read a couple of A-tier prominent indie English visual novels such as Katawa Shoujo, Lucid 9, or Doki Doki Literature Club, you won't even know where to start. I wouldn't even think about making a visual novel if I haven't even read some of the highest received English and Japanese visual novels. Note, from here on out, we're at the starting line. I shouldn't have even needed to mention the last 2 points, but I wanted to make this video completely clear. If you see visual novels as a joke genre, that doesn't mean we do. If you're one-off, one-hour, Ren'py, fanfiction-esque, unedited, ugly, piece-of-shit visual novel is not well-received, well, that's not our problem. So don't come crying back to us. 9 times out of 10, VN developers come up with a premise that has already been overdone. If your premise is unoriginal, why would I bother reading it over a longer, high-quality, voice-acted Japanese equivalent? I wouldn't. You'll notice a lot of moege have moved away from standard slice-of-life scenarios to standard slice-of-life scenarios with a twist. A great example of a visual novel I recently finished with this sort of thing is called Chrono Clock, whereby the protagonist has the ability to go back in time by 5 minutes. Now, this premise may seem interesting, if not a little bit underwhelming. However, this same premise can be used to show off your creativity. In what ways could the protagonist use this ability? How could it impact the story? The premise is just as important for you and your ability to shape an interesting story around it as it is to draw people in. So before you go and make Danganronpa 54 or Doki Doki Literature Club +++, try to give it some more thought. Now for Bruce's unethical tip of the day. Sometimes you'll find yourself making a difficult decision, such as what premise should you use for your visual novel? When that happens, why not go through some popular untranslated Japanese visual novels and steal get inspiration from them, focusing on premises that may not currently be explored in a currently translated English visual novel. Your idea will be new, and if you get called out, feign ignorance. It's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. I'm a man who hated English class with a passion, so it's probably no surprise that I hate writing stories, essays, and YouTube scripts. But visual novels are visual novels. You get me? Unless you're writing some quickie, sonic fanfiction visual novel, a lot of planning goes into creating a good novel. Visual novels can arguably be even worse because you have to take in consideration branching paths as well as dialogue that may be affected by choices you made like an hour ago. There are greater men than I that might explain how you go about this. But just know that it's pretty clear when a story is written from beginning to end without forethought, because it's usually painful to read. So you got a great idea. You may even have a general structure on how to approach that idea. Maybe you even already started a rough draft. Great. Don't add to it. In any project, it's absolutely integral to start your idea off with a plan of execution. So once you've got that, stick to it. It's not a crime to add another scene or two if you think it might be necessary to foreshadow an upcoming event or for a character's development, but be reasonable with yourself. Don't decide on a whim just to add another route or two just because you can, because burnout is real. You either won't finish your visual novel to begin with, or your original idea may just simply end up becoming shallow because of splitting of resources, even if that only resource was you. The novel of your visual novel may be the selling point, but the visuals are the hook. Sprites, CGs, you've got one chance to impress somebody into buying your visual novel, so don't hold back. Unless your visual novel looks like this. And then hold back as much as you can and fire your artist. Kevin has been making great copyright-free tracks since as long as I can remember, and has livened up YouTubers, film enthusiasts, and game developers' arsenals with a large genre variety of soundtracks. That is to say, we've heard them all before. You don't need an original soundtrack for your visual novel, but if you are using these copyright-free libraries, I implore you to at least look for more obscure ones that are not often used. But please, I beg of you, don't use this one. Ren'py gets a bad rep because it is the easiest way to make a visual novel with the cost of a limited engine. Many times these visual novels have similar looking UI, and a lot of the bottom of the barrel visual novels do use Ren'py. But take the stick out of your ass for a minute. Doki Doki Literature Club was made on Ren'py. If you insist on using Unity because of the stigma that Ren'py carries, then be the change you want to see instead of putting the cart in front of the horse. If you're making an indie visual novel that you want others to enjoy, stop worrying about anything that I've not mentioned. Except maybe potential audience if you do go ahead and make that furry Fuda porn game. At the end of the day, as long as the core of your visual novel is good, the writing, decent visuals, a soundtrack that's, you know, it gets there, people will enjoy your game even if you didn't have much of a budget. If you can aim for a visual novel as good as Sepia Tears, then I think you're in a good place. I'll end things with this. Visual novel developers, feel free to send me your visual novels, and I will take a look at them and tell you everything I don't like about them. You'll definitely be humbled, but maybe it'll help you out. Be it 5 minutes, months, or years after this video releases, and hell, if I get enough of them, maybe I'll even make a video out of it. Thanks for watching. Your visual novel may very well be hot garbage, but I don't want it to be.